Yo, what's up, guys? Hope you guys are all doing great today. I'm pretty excited because we have been news today that got leaked from Charlie Intel and from Infinite Warfare. So that they released the new DLC pack number 2, which is gonna be called Continuum. So it's gonna be released on April 18th. So in just a bit more than 2 weeks here, that's gonna be crazy. I mean, I don't know about you guys. Just before I get into the map pack, I want to talk about the first map pack that came out, DLC 1. To be honest, I bought it because I don't have the season pass, so I just buy them, you know, just on the whatever I want. But to be honest, I was actually really I was disappointed a bit about the first map pack. I don't think that map pack was actually really good. To be honest, all maps were pretty huge. You know, the Afghan remake map was kind of okay, but thing is, was just too big for this kind of game. You know, that map was a lot of fun where that time where you would snipe all the time on MW2 and, you know, those times. But I don't think for now it's the right map for this kind of game. So a lot of people were complaining about those maps. Renaissance was kind of okay, but I mean, the three other maps, Neon, Noir, and Dominion, I don't think they're good at all. So, and I don't think they were a huge success. So, yeah, now we're going to get into the second one right away. So, the four maps, I'll just name you guys the maps and tell you a bit how they are. So, we got Turista, which is the first one, which is kind of like a really futuristic map. There's just been leaked image, so we can just see the image, but we can't, you know, there's not much to say about it. So, there's Turista, which is, like I said, kind of a futuristic map. Then you got Scrap, which is like in the snow, which a lot of, you know, barrels and stuff. It kind of looks like, you know, kind of frost, but in more like a darker map or kind of stuff. Then you got Excess, which that one's going to be probably my favorite. The reason why is it's going to be the remake of Rust from MW2. If you guys played Modern Warfare 2, for sure you know that map. That was the map, you know, everyone liked. And that was probably the most played map. And what I'm really happy about, I'm a guy who likes to spawn trap and stuff. There has to be a spawn trap for Rust. That map's smaller. For those of you guys who don't know Rust, Rust is about half the size of Genesis, alright? It's a bit bigger than Shipment, if you guys played the remastered, but it's kind of the same layout. Like, the map is squared, just like Shipment, just a bit wider, but, you know, it's almost as quick as, you know, the kills and everything are gonna come really quick. There's gonna be a lot of quick streaks happening in that map. So, it's not gonna be like Rust where it was the time, you know, where there was sand and kind of stuff. It more looks like grass now and more like futuristic, like Infinite Warfare. So, pretty excited for that map. Then we got another map, the last map, which is called Archive. So I have no idea really what this map looks, because we only see a picture. The only picture that's being leaked is inside a building. Like I said, still futuristic also, but we can't really see more. We just see like a shark with kind of a balloon or ball over his head in a little room. But there's not much else to say about that. And then for the zombies players, I don't play zombies, but for the zombies players out there, there's going to be Shaolin Shuffle, which I don't really know what that means. When you look at the picture they leaked, I don't know if Chinese or Japanese sign, but there is some, you know, that kind of letters. It's not like letters like English or whatever. You guys know what I mean by that. So the writing's really different. And even the shapes of the buildings, you guys know if you ever seen pictures of just China or whatever, Japan, you know, the buildings are more like triangle roofs, and it kind of looks like that. So I don't know if it's going to be kind of like that or what time it's going to take place, but it looks something like Asian, all right? So that's it for the five maps. So there's four on multiplayer, and then there's one on zombies, which is going to be absolutely cool. I can't wait for it to come out. To be honest, I want to know, guys, in the comment section below, let me know if you guys want to buy this map pack. What do you guys think about that map pack? After the first one that's been leased, DLC 1, a lot of people were not happy with it. So, Let me know, guys. Even though if you have season passes, you guys really want to download the maps. What's your plan regarding that? So I actually was not going to buy them, but now there's going to be the excess, which is Rust, that's going to be in. So I'm like indecided if I want it or not, because I'd like to just buy Rust and then all those other maps, just don't play them. But I don't know yet. So I wanted to you guys to let me know down in the comment section what you guys are going to do. And also, I just wanted to take a little time just to thank everyone for the support we've had lately. This is crazy. We're almost at 600 subs. So if you guys are new, don't forget to subscribe. I'd be really happy about it. And can we reach 15 likes today? So that's our goal for today, 15 likes. So smash that like button. And now I just want to show you guys here a little clip, which has nothing to do with the DLC, but it's pretty cool. So look at this. So I'm in Frost here, just playing, just chilling. Pop a personal radar, just go in there. So I see all my personal radars, are one on my left. I see him go in active camo right there. I just spray. I'm like, dude. And I got him. So that's it, guys. So I'll see you soon. Peace out.